What TV or movie cliche drives you insane? Every time someone wakes up in a hospital, the first thing they do is rip the IV out of their arm. And no catheter. Sneaky helicopters, the ones that suddenly appear with a great wall of sound 10 foot in front of the movie's protagonist without warning. This crescendo of classical music will mask our helicopter ambush quite nicely. Infinite gears in car chases, and constant revving creases. We have to go now. Why? What's up? There's no time. What's happening? You're not listening. You could have already said the reason. People's inability to wait for backup. Come on now. Backup should be here any minute. Frick IT. Imma do this on my own. Eat lead cockroaches. Whenever someone is in a hurry to get away, the car struggles to start. If I was a mechanic and someone called me and said their car would not start, I would say, hey, maybe a killer is after you, Mitch H. If the good guy is shot in the torso, they never, ever die. I mean, the good guy rarely dies in any movie, but if he's grasping anywhere near his shoulder when the bullet hits, I won't be surprised to see him alive in the final scene. Bad guy shot to the foot equals insta-kill. Crime procedurals where an off-topic conversation with a random secondary character makes one of the detectives realize what he needs to solve the crime. A. Hey Jim, how was your day? B. Great, Mike, except when one of my students growled at me for waking him up during class. A. Haha, growled at you? Wait, the dog that growled at every police officer at the crime scene didn't growl at all during the 911 call the Vic made before he died. He must have been killed by someone the dog is friendly with. The only person that could be is the next door neighbor. I gotta go, Jim. Thanks. Boy meets girl. Boy tells girl lie to impress her. Boy and girl fall in love. Boy tells girl truth. Our entire relationship is based on a lie. Did you ever even love me? I didn't sign up for this. Yes, you did. You are a police officer. It's in the job description, butthole. When a character answers a phone and is overly descriptive, making sure you can follow both sides of the phone conversation. For example, hi, Mary, yes, I took out the garbage. No, I will not be home before 7. The quirky, weird, different forensic people in crime shows. The pathologist who eats his sandwiches in the morgue. When a cop is close to solving a case, he'll be suspended from duty, which he'll ignore. And then get his job back with everything forgotten once he solves it. In movies, everyone types 250 WPM and never ever uses a mouse. But, they are hacking into the mainframe using Unix macros and a CI. If something really tall is falling in your direction, be sure to run away from it in a direction that lies along where it will land. When you end a phone conversation with someone, never say goodbye, just hang up the phone. That in a dangerous situation that involves family, the kids start doing stupid things. You freaking kids should start listening to their parents. Oh, and when they are on the run, the wife always falls or does something she thinks is best for the situation. The purge would have never happened had it been for that freaking bicycle helmet wearing kid. Delaying the murder of the hero while explaining entire evil mastermind plan. I triggered it 35 minutes ago. I am a paramedic. On TV or the movies, the EKG monitor goes flatline and they immediately shock with the paddles. You do not do this. In fact, when you shock, you make the heart flatline. Stop the heart, in hopes that the natural pacemaker in the heart will regroup and start firing in a normal manner. Also, the loud thump sound you hear when they fire the defibrillator and shock. You make hear a click sound, but that's about it. The good guy can always fight off multiple attackers. Why are they just standing around watching their buddy get beat up? Why are they taking turns? Look, they're just standing there. Attack him. It's the perfect opportunity. Oh, great. Now he's beating you up because you wouldn't attack when you could have had some assistance. Never attack Jackie Chan in a furniture store. When the science guy is explaining something to the main character using complicated technical sounding terms, the first response is always some variation of English. Please. I always hated what happens right after that, when the science guy does some big technical sounding speech, and when the other person responds the scientist happens to have a simple metaphor, gives a 4-minute explanation of huge security flaw in alien technology. English please, doc, we're gonna use the back door, comma dear god, it's so crazy it just might work. Young 20-something year old with a low-paying job in New York? Let's have that character live in a giant apartment right in the middle of Manhattan. Wherever you need to go on this planet, there's always an available and wide-open parking space directly in front of your destination. Walking away from an explosion and not looking back. Just one time I want to see someone get hit with some shrapnel that would have missed if they had cowered slightly. Bad guys have terrible aim cliche, good guys only ever need a bullet or two. Also the fact that guns seem to never need reloading, ridiculous. See, I don't mind when your regular bad guys miss, but when the bad guys are super elite soldiers, with their super elite training, and they have over 300 confirmed kills and then they suddenly forget which part of the gun shoots the bullet, I'm not even gonna start talking about the good guys and their godlike aim. When pregnant women go into labor, OMG, I'm having one contraction. Everybody freak out and run me to the hospital immediately because this baby is going to fall out of my vagina in 3 minutes. Yeah, it doesn't work that way, unless maybe it's her 4th or 5th pregnancy, but it never is on TV. You usually are in labor for at least 6 hours, up to 40 or 50. Plenty of time to not panic and get your butt to the hospital. Every movie being set in a parallel universe where there is no movie industry, or at least no movie that is even remotely similar to their situation. That way people can be blissfully ignorant about the cliches they are in. This is easy for me. I can't stand that 8-14-year-old kid who gives the main character really deep and down-to-earth advice like, she's your soulmate, right? Go after her. Modern Family abused this formula with Manny quite a bit, but they managed to put a bit of irony behind it. It doubles in annoyance when the main character gives an astonished reaction to their surprising amount of insight. It gets me so mad. Arrested Development did this once, where Mibi, who had lied her way into a job as a film executive at 16, gave her Uncle Gob the advice to tell him the truth. He'll respect you for it. Immediately followed by okay, now I'm just lying for no reason. It's like a requirement of modern horror movies that someone at some point exclaims, what do you want from me? You drop this. People being illogical and stupid just to further the story. The Walking Dead, I'm looking at you. Especially in sitcoms, when one character asks another character to step aside so they can talk in secrecy. Mofo, you are literally 3 feet away from the guy you're trying to hide the convo from. Love triangles, hands down. They can ruin a show movie. The scientists that get to work on the most expensive space exploring mission ever, suddenly become blatant idiots. Remove their breathing helmet, without knowing if the air is breathable, or start touching the carnivorous plants. Will they, won't they? It's why I stopped watching Grey's Anatomy. My wife watches a lot of Korean drama. The things that bother the crap out of me are the following. The male love interest is always rich. Like, insanely rich. Richer than rich. Has 3 mansions filled with maids, butlers, and solid gold toilets. The female is always poor and needs saving with the male love interest's money. The male and female leads will initially hate each other because reasons. The obligatory running to the hospital scene. The obligatory someone gets run over after an argument scene. The obligatory slow motion arm grab scene. S. Despite being in the capital city of a densely populated country, you can park anywhere at any time. Body swapping. In terms of Western movies and TV shows, I have to say I hate rich people problems. You know the ones. Daddy can buy me everything but my love. I'm so lonely I'll mope about in my mansion, etc. People are complete dongs on the phone. They ring a number, mumble a manly one-liner, and hang up. Surely the wrong number has been rung many times and the guy at Pizza Hut is like, what? Probably bled over from rich problems. But people who seem to have unlimited amount of free time and money. Someone in college convinced me to watch Sex and the City and I spent the entire episode questioning how someone who has a weekly column, not even a full page, can have such a lavish lifestyle. People with autism are automatically super geniuses. Hacking. or just how computers work in general, cocking guns and guns that make clicky noises by pointing them at things. Hey, at least it's not Filipino dramas where the character is either 1. Composed entirely of holy water, 2. A ghost, or 3. A sea serpent mermaid whose love interest is a soldier part of the resistance planning to eradicate her peoples. Lack of proper communication leads to a misunderstanding. Cliche. Open your mouth and tell the entire story. Holy crap, that is the worst. Let me explain. I have a simple, one-sentence explanation that would defuse this whole argument. No, I'm done listening to your excuses. Now I'm going to turn and leave down this long hallway while you just stand there sighing and looking helpless. Ancient world equals pure white marble statues. If you see a perfectly white Greek or Roman statue, it's either a modern one, or some idiot curator thought it was dirty and scrubbed the remains of the original paint off. Also, every single trap and mechanism in a 1,000-year-old tomb is still in tip-top shape, except for cobwebs. Person 1 admits to being in love with someone to person 2. Person 2 is crushed because they were in love with person 1, until they find out that person 1 means them. You only get one shot. One shot is all I need. Every dang time. 3D computer operating systems and hackers who hack some super high-end encryption in 10 seconds while getting a BJ. I can't remember a movie where there wasn't a love interest. I watched Hot Fuzz last night. I'd forgotten how refreshing it was being able to enjoy the movie without some menial romance thrown in there for the sake of it. We Germans are always the bad guys, have no sense of humor and are very rude to other people. Frick this crap, frick you all. I hate this. Every time a World War II movie comes out, they make us Germans the bad guys. Every date in the USA ever has started by someone picking up someone else at 8. Everyone seemed to get Knicks, Mets, Giants, Rangers, Lakers, insert team name, tickets all the time, free of charge, courtside seats, behind the dugout. I'm not from USA, so I may be wrong, but it seems to me that getting that kind of seats, or for that matter tickets for big games on a regular basis if you are not a season ticket holder, would not be that easy. Hey, this guy I know gave me 4 Super Bowl tickets. Wanna go? Sure. No one ever just coughs. If someone coughs, they'll be in hospital in the next scene. Same for scratching your itching arm or sneezing. This is a gold spongiger. It only appears once every 1 million spongiger memes, like in 5 seconds or bad luck. You have been visited by money bird. Upvote in 5861 seconds and you will get rich. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check out another video. Or don't. Either way, have a great day, you magnificent people.